What's up, mate? Madison fucking Twatter here. This video is obviously a bit different. You may know me for making videos about how to grow on Twitch or other social media, but I'm using a face cam for the first time since my HOS0312 exposed video because I'm going to be showing you guys how to set up a green screen with Streamlabs in 2022. This will also work with Stream Elements, OBS, and the other major streaming / recording platforms. It will look basically the same and consist of the same steps. If you don't know, green screens are extremely easy to use to have whatever background you want. So if you want Lieutenant Twatter or Mr. Twatter, easily switch between multiple scenes and multiple different backgrounds. First, this is what you need to get started. One, you need Streamlabs, Stream Elements, or any of the other streaming / recording platforms. Two, you need a webcam. Three, a green curtain. It doesn't have to be perfectly straight or even a curtain at all. I'm going to be showing you how I got creative with what I use. But if you do want a curtain, you can get this one here on Amazon. Like I said, you don't need to worry about folds or anything like that. So this is my Streamlabs. This is what it looks like. Ignore all of these scenes over here. You just want to make a new scene. I made a new one called Twatter Love Streamer. This is just the display capture so you guys can see what's on my screen right now. First, you're going to want to pick your background. So we go here, go to image, add source, add a new image instead. What do I want to call this? If you don't know, I'm working on a GTA 5 RP server. It should be coming out very soon. So you want to go and do your pictures or whatever and pick your background. You could also use a video, like if you want to use a video of a hot tub or fighting going on behind you or whatever you want to use. You could choose any picture or video to use. You could also use your game captures. So if you want to have Call of Duty in the background or whatever game you're playing, it works just the same. We could use my display capture for an example. So because this picture is over the display capture, that is what will be seen here. So let's go back to the display capture for now, just so you can see exactly what I'm doing. Add another source. We'll do video capture device, add source. I'm already gonna add my existing source. Let me take off the filters. So this is what it looks like right now with just the webcam. As you can see, I just have a green background. This is a wall that just got painted green. It's not even the exact green screen color. It's a lot darker in real life than it looks on camera. It looks really light on camera, but in real life, it's basically the same color as a green screen. And you can't see, but right behind the webcam to the left of it is where I have my ring light, and it's aimed right at the back of here. So as you can see, it's lighting up the wall behind me. Here, let's go ahead and make this small so you can see. So what you're gonna wanna do next, right click on video capture device, go to filters, edit filters. You're gonna wanna add a new filter, filter type, chroma key, filter name, name it whatever you want. All of these settings, you wanna pretty much make exactly what mine is, except for similarity. Keep similarity at 1 right now and just copy these settings. 1 color key spill reduction, 1 smoothness, 100 opacity, 0.11 on contrast, 0 on brightness, 0 on gamma. Just do this to set it up, and then afterwards you could play with it and see what works best for you. But most of these you're not gonna even wanna mess with. You got green, you got blue, you got magenta or custom. Once you got those sorted, similarity is what's really important. So this is what's going to take and get rid of the color. See, for me, 435 doesn't really pull any of the color. 507 starts to pull color, but you still see, you know, this right here, this over here. I don't want to see none of that. 600, I'm gone. The magic number for me, 520. That's the best I can get. Still, you know, it's not perfect, and I can even mess with these settings to try to fix it or whatever. But similarity is what's going to pull the color away. So how it works, it just pulls all the green and makes it black. So then once we close this out, make this big again, and now hold Alt and then drag your camera over to the cutoff point, because otherwise you can see my desktop in the background. I don't like that. Drag that, cut that off. Perfect. Just hold Alt, drag, cut that off. Now you could drag this around, you can resize it, make it smaller, put me in the corner, or you can be really big and just have whatever behind you. So that is exactly how I got this set up. Oh, something important. See how my camera, it's inverted right now. And if you don't want it inverted, just go to right click, go to transform, and then flip horizontally. Boom, the camera's normal. That's how it should be. Some people like having it inverted, I do not. So now if we turn off that and turn on this, let's resize it up. That's how you set up a green screen in 2022 with Streamlabs or any of the other streaming platforms. All you have to do is follow these steps and you'll have a green screen. It's very easy. You can even make it look way better than mine pretty easily, but I don't fuck with my settings. I hope this video was helpful. Leave a like, subscribe if you can. Send this to anybody who's a streamer. Send this to any rappers. Rappers love using green screens. You can do a lot with this as far as content creation, and I hope this was helpful, and I hope you guys can take this and make something dope with it. See ya, mate.